Louis was just a pure athlete. I mean, he's solid muscle. And he didn't come from a water polo background, so his freshman year, he was a swimmer. He had swam all his life and didn't know how to play water polo. You know, Coach Rogers took Louis and just molded him into a specimen of a water polo player.
Coming into Bellarmine, Louis was very good. He's got a lot of accolades in high school, everything from All-Americans there all the time, all that, to record holder. He was a 500 free record holder when he left. He was top two in the 100 free, top two in the 200 free when he left the school and everything.
As a teammate, you'd just see white water. He was just a fire plug in the water and an amazing speed, could shoot the ball harder than anybody. It was solid muscle. He was the only person I ever knew. It was his freshman year when Larry would say, okay, we're gonna go the weights, you know, 6 to 8. He'd have a note from his doctor saying, Louis Nicolau was already too big and he's not allowed to lift weights. And we'd look and go, yeah. So he never lifted a day in his life.
After he left Bellarmine, he went to the Naval Academy, our four-year player, three-time All-American for the Naval Academy, won their top Silver Sword award his senior year, played part of the U.S. national team, played in the World University Games team.
He changed the culture of the East Coast water polo. I mean, East Coast water polo to California was a joke, really, before Louis went out. And there was a game, I think it was my junior year, where Navy was playing a California team, I think it was Long Beach, and it was a game. Going into the fourth quarter, it was a 1 or 2 goal game. I think the final score was, let's say, 10-7 for Long Beach, but Louis had scored all 7 goals for Navy and it kept them in the game. And I don't think any East Coast team had ever beaten a California team before that. So the whole place was going crazy watching Louis single-handedly take this team on the East Coast and compete with a California team.
He made an immediate impact on the as a freshman on the Navy team. In fact, he was the Eastern Freshman of the Year, and he helped Navy win the NC2A Eastern Championship and the trip to the NC2A Final 8 tournament my senior year.
Then did his naval service. After that, got married to Kelly, went to Princeton, became the head men's and women's water polo coach there, has done really well.
One of the things that everybody really felt on the team is he just really engaged with us as people more than players. And you can just tell that he really cares about everybody individually and sort of always there to lend an ear, lighten the mood, make you laugh.
It's no surprise when he finished college playing that he dedicated his career to coaching, you know, to helping others succeed. And that's just the way he was as an unselfish person.
But I feel like his success is like partially reflected in the success of the program, but it's really more reflected in the community that he's built around the teams. It's wild. Every year, Princeton is very famous for having a really lively reunion scene, and people go back many different years. There's an alumni games. It used to be there'd be 5-10 alums that show up. Now it's like well into the double digits. It's huge groups of people coming back. I feel like he fostered this family environment when we were there. Like, we hang out at his house, we babysat his kids, his family was coming to the pool, he would have people over. In between the women's team and the men's team, it was just this like total feeling of family away from home, and then I think it just sort of never stopped.
He knows what he's doing, and he also knows how to keep it fun. And the players respond to that. It's like Rocky Jackson. He just goes and wins wherever he goes, and yet he does it right. He does it the right way.
I've always said, you know, Louis, I would be honored if you would coach my son, which I think is the biggest compliment that you can entrust your friend, is to, you know, to keep an eye out for your son and teach him, you know, the fundamentals of water polo in college and look out for him.
There's never been a person I know that dislikes Louis. In the classes, you know, here at Bellarmine, he was just that guy that everybody liked to talk to, that, you know, was concerned with everybody, got along with everybody, the teachers all liked him. And as a result, that true personality or that interest came out and affected everybody.